The second model for providing virtualization of physical devices is to allow the hypervisor to first intercept every single possible device access that's performed by a guest VM. Once the hypervisor has the information about the device operation that the guest VM wanted to perform, it doesn't have a requirement that the device that the guest VM wants and the physical device match. So the hypervisor would first translate that device access to some generic representation of an IO operation for that particular family of devices, whether they're network devices or disk devices. And then it will traverse the hypervisor resident, the VMM resident IO stack. So the bottom of that stack is the actual real device driver, and the hypervisor will invoke that device driver and perform the IO operation on behalf of the guest VM. Clearly, a key benefit of this approach is that now the virtual machine is again decoupled from the physical device. Any translation, any emulation will be performed by the hypervisor layer. And because of that, operations such as sharing and migration or the requirements of how we need to deal with device specifics, all of that becomes simpler in a sense. This is a model that's originally adapted by the VMware ESX hypervisor. The downside of the model is that it clearly adds latency on device accesses because of this emulation step. And then also, it requires that the device driver ecosystem is in certain ways integrated with the hypervisor. Now, the hypervisor needs to support all of the drivers so that it can perform the necessary operations. And the hypervisor is then exposed to all of the complexities of and bugs of various device drivers. Again, we said earlier in the case of VMware, because of its market share, this model was a reasonable model and it made sense and it's been sustainable because of that.